Hey guys, welcome back to Oak Abode. Today I'm answering one of the most common questions that I get in our comments, which is, what do you feed backyard chickens? As usual, I wrote a whole blog post on the answer to this question, so if you guys prefer to read instead of watch, you can click the link in the description and that will take you to our website. But I'm gonna go through the five basic things that we feed our backyard chickens and why. Now, I really try to simplify my chicken care videos, so I don't want you guys to get nervous or think that there's an exact science to this. I'm just gonna break down kind of the five key areas and then let you use your best judgment for how you're gonna apply that to your own chicken flock. Okay, I'm looking at it now and there are six key areas that I'm gonna go over. The first component that we feed our backyard chickens, and this is arguably the most important component, is obviously layer feed. Now, if you are raising baby chicks or if you're laying chickens that are not really egg layers, you're gonna wanna use a different mix, probably a starter grower mix or perhaps a scratch mixture. But most of us are raising backyard chickens because we enjoy the eggs, and layer feed is really important for egg laying chickens for a few reasons. So layer feed is going to provide kind of the bulk of nutrition to your chickens. Some people who are really into kind of like really organic approach, or if they're trying to grow their own food for their chickens, they might put together their own scratch mixture. This is not something that we do and not something I necessarily recommend for beginners, because chicken nutrition is pretty nuanced, believe it or not. And if your chickens don't have access to a wide range of foods through free ranging or other means, it's kind of hard to feed them exactly what they need if they don't have the freedom to get it themselves. Now, the reason that layer feed is really important for egg-laying chickens is because most of it is fortified with extra calcium. So the chickens go through a lot of calcium, especially since a lot of breeds that we use in backyard flocks have been bred to lay kind of more than they would many years ago. So because they're bred to lay a lot of eggs, their body needs a lot of calcium. So the layer feed is going to add calcium, help keep those nice hard eggshells. I'll go into this a little bit more in a little bit, but soft eggshells are not just a pain in the butt for people collecting the eggs, but they're also dangerous to chickens too. So you want your chickens to have enough calcium. The layer feed is going to help with that. A lot of people ask us what brand we feed our chickens. Right now, I think we're feeding them Dewmore. We have fed them though basically any brand that's at the local tractor supply or the local feed store that is on sale. So I pretty much just grab whatever's cheapest. But if you're somebody who cares about organic feed, or you're really interested in where your chicken food is sourced, that's probably something you're gonna want to look into a little bit more. I don't personally worry about it too much because our chickens get a large bulk of what they consume just through free ranging. They don't eat a ton of layer feed, but especially for confined flocks, that might be something that you want to look into a little bit more. As usual, I will link what we use for you below. In addition to having extra calcium, the layer feed is probably gonna provide your chickens with a good portion, if not the majority, of the calories that they consume and the nutrition that they need. Getting a little fights back there. Number two on my list of things that we feed our backyard chickens is healthy training treats. Now, if I had watched this video when I was a new chicken owner, I would have laughed at myself and I would have said that I'm being way too high maintenance and you don't need to buy training treats. That's partially true. Chickens will eat a lot of things as treats, but there is a reason that I'm saying healthy training treats, because healthy training treats can be beneficial to their health. I'll go into that more in a second. So, what do we use for healthy training treats? We use Grubterra black soldier fly larvae. A lot of people will use mealworms, and mealworms are fine. From what I've heard, mealworms don't offer a lot in terms of nutritional content. They're kind of like the potato chips of the chicken world. So the reason that we use black soldier fly larvae instead is because black soldier fly larvae has a lot more calcium than mealworms, significantly more, to the point where we don't actually have to feed our chickens oyster shells anymore since we started feeding them the black soldier fly larva in combination with their layer feed. So we use the layer feed and the black soldier fly larva. In our experience with our free ranging hens, their eggs have been nice and hard. We just stopped giving them oyster shells about a year ago, never had any issues. I'll go into the oyster shells in a second, but our chickens much prefer the black soldier fly larva and we prefer to use them too. We want to give Grubterra a huge thank you for always keeping us supplied with our black soldier fly larva. If you guys want, you can use the code OAKABODE for, I believe, 10% off of your order. So I will link it for you guys below and make sure to use the code OAKABODE for a discount. The other reason that I encourage black soldier fly larvae as training treats is because, especially now that we live on acreage, it's actually a safety issue that our chickens come when called. So it's really helpful to kind of have the sound sound of the exact bag that we use, in addition to just calling, you know, here girls, come here. When they hear that bag crinkle and when they hear that call, they know that they're gonna get some black soldier fly larvae. They absolutely love it. Not only is it gonna be good for them, but it has helped us more than once get them out of dense bushes where we never would have found them. So I just call them and they come running out every single time, sometimes from very far away. You can probably get the same effect from using like kitchen scraps and maybe banging on a plastic container or something. You know, it's possible to get the same effect. I'm not saying that you have to buy these specific treats to have well-trained chickens. I have noticed though that they are much more responsive to the exact same sound, the exact same product than when we feed them kitchen scraps, which sometimes are not as exciting as they would like them to be, which I'll go into in a second. So the third thing on my list of things to feed backyard chickens is kitchen scraps. So obviously one of the benefits of keeping backyard chickens is that they are fantastic recycling bins. They will take many kitchen scraps that might otherwise have gone just in the garbage or maybe in the compost pile if you are a composter, and they will turn them into farm fresh eggs, and they will have fun doing it, which is part of the fun. Now it's important to note that there are certain foods that chickens should not eat and should not be fed. Some of them, I'm not gonna go through an exhaustive list here. Now, I'm just going off of what I have been told and what I have heard. I always recommend you guys do lots of outside research besides just what I'm saying, but I've been told that raw onions are not safe for chickens, raw potatoes, specifically the raw potato peels, supposedly, chocolate, avocado. There's kind of like random foods that are not necessarily ones that should be fed to chickens. So I listed some of those in the blog post if you wanna go into it more. I've also heard people say that you can't feed chickens tomatoes. We feed our chickens tomatoes, they absolutely love them. And I think some people err more on the side of caution and control when it comes to what you can feed chickens, and people more like myself, I try and just go by general rules. Now, if you're somebody who is trying to decide if you're gonna get chickens or not, and you're afraid you're gonna feed them something wrong and hurt them, one thing that I've noticed is that chickens are actually pretty darn good at discerning what they can eat and what they can't, as long as they have plenty of different foods to choose from. So when I was a new chicken owner, I actually regularly gave my chickens raw onions. I think I did give them raw potatoes. I know I tried to feed them a caterpillar that I later found out was toxic. The interesting thing is that the chickens wouldn't eat them. So they wouldn't touch the onions. I never knew why, I just figured they didn't like them. The caterpillar that was a toxic caterpillar, they actually looked at and kind of did like an alarm call. They somehow kind of knew that it was toxic, which I later found out. I'm not saying this to say that you should feed your chickens everything. For example, if you try and feed them chocolate cake, I'm sure they're gonna eat the chocolate cake because it's got all that sugar and carbs, even though they shouldn't have chocolate. So definitely do your research, but also just know that a lot of us have made mistakes along the way, and just because you gave your chickens something that you later learned they shouldn't have doesn't necessarily mean that your chickens are doomed. So I always recommend making sure that they have a large selection of foods, plenty of food to choose from, so they don't feel like they have to eat something that is gonna be dangerous for them if they're starving. Some other foods, people say you shouldn't feed them like junk foods or sugary foods and that kind of thing. I recommend doing as much outside research as possible because there are many different opinions on the subject. The fourth thing that you should probably consider when it comes to what to feed backyard chickens is calcium supplementation, like I mentioned. Probably the most common form of calcium supplementation, aside from just calcium fortified layer feed, is going to be oyster shells. So a lot of people use oyster shells to help chickens keep hard eggs. I think what people usually do is just put a dish of them to the side, and you don't typically see chickens eating from it, but supposedly they will pick from it if they need it. When we got a few brittle eggs early in our chicken keeping career, we did bring in the oyster shells. That being said, personally, I find it so much easier and more enjoyable to use the calcium fortified layer feed in combination with plenty of Grubterra black soldier fly larva treats, just kind of when I bring them in for the night. And I can only speak from personal experience, but we have beautiful hard eggshells all the time. We haven't supplemented with oyster shells for at least a year, which is why we no longer buy mealworms. But that being said, calcium supplementation should be something that most chicken owners are at least watching for, if not providing at all time. If you are getting chickens with brittle eggs, it is not only a pain for egg collection when the eggs are breaking all the time, but also it can be dangerous for chickens. It can disrupt their laying pattern. It can make it difficult for for them to lay, which can be a life-threatening problem. So you definitely want to make sure that they have enough calcium as well. I love how when I started filming, they were like on the other side of the farm and they saw that I'm over here. So now they just want to hang out here. They are such funny little girls. The fourth area I want to address of what you should feed backyard chickens is grit. So if you are new to chicken keeping or bird keeping in general, grit is basically what chickens use to break down food since they don't chew food mechanically with a jaw like we would. So grit is like basically stuff that they can't digest, little rocks, little pebbles that will sit in their gizzard and that will grind together and break down food so that the chickens can digest it. Now, I think a lot of people worry about grit maybe more than a lot of them have to, not something you should write off completely, but if your chickens are free ranging like ours, or if they have a lot of access to the outdoors, there's a good chance that they are gonna be able to get grit on their own just from the dirt. And that is one of the reasons I am really big on free ranging. I really like that it allows them to get the exact grit that they need. However, if you are raising baby chicks who are confined in a very artificial container, which most of us do to keep them safe, or if you have chickens in a very confined area where they don't have access to lots of dirt that they can turn over and find new pebbles, if that sounds more like your chicken keeping situation, then it is gonna be important that you provide a little dish of grit at all times so that they can kind of pick at it as they need it. I do know, I think some people just kind of sprinkle the grit occasionally on top of the food, which is an option as well. Again, it's just so much easier for me to let them out and take care of it themselves. Finally, the last area I want to address regarding what to feed backyard chickens is free-range finds. As you guys know by now, I love free-ranging chickens. It does come with more risk, so from predator attacks and that kind of thing, but free-ranging can actually be a significant portion of your chicken's diet. Another reason that I love to free range our birds is because we save a lot on layer feed. We go through a lot less layer feed than people who keep confined backyard flocks, and that is totally fine with me. So not only do we save money by purchasing less layer feed, we save more headache by hauling less layer feed around, but what's most important is I love that our chickens get arguably the most natural diet possible. So when it comes to food and nutrition for humans, I'm passionate about not entirely, but a largely plant-based diet, having a wide variety of foods and a wide variety of veggies specifically. And if we're gonna raise our own backyard chickens, I want to make sure that they are getting a similar diet because they're gonna pass those nutrients along to us in the eggs. So chickens who are just eating corn-based layer feed alone, the nutrients in the eggs are not gonna be the same as the chickens who are free ranging, who are eating bugs, who are eating grubs, who are eating lots of different leafy greens. And really, they are pros at finding a wide variety of good stuff outside. So I absolutely love free ranging our chickens as much as possible so that they can get a wide variety of micronutrients that they are then gonna pass along into the eggs to us. I get a lot of questions from people on chicken illnesses. And the reality is that we have not had to deal with almost any chicken illnesses, which I believe is largely attributed to the fact that our birds spend a lot of time in plenty of space free ranging with a wide, wide variety of foods that they're eating. Like I've said before, the only illness we've really had to deal with was sauerkraut, which was when they were chicks in a confined environment. And I do believe that was due to the apple cider vinegar. If you want to feed your chickens apple cider vinegar, that's totally fine. We stopped giving ours apple cider vinegar. We have never had a worm problem. We've never had other illnesses, and we stopped getting cases of sauerkraut. So that's all that I will say there. Long story short, if you can't free range your hens, not everybody can, and that's okay. If possible, maybe try and simulate a free ranging environment. So I'll be totally honest, certain days our hens don't get out to free range. On those days, I try and at least pick some garlic mustard, pick some weeds, pick some grass, throw it in their pen so that they can pick from that. There's probably gonna be little bugs and things on there that'll at least hold them over for the day. So if you can't free range hens, it's not the end of the world. You can always pick stuff from outside, or you can provide them a wider variety of kitchen scraps to choose from as well. One last note about the kitchen scraps. The other thing I wanna say be careful of is be careful of feeding them too many like really, really yummy foods, because our chickens' favorite foods are meat and carbs. So they absolutely love like pasta and breads and any kind of meat they will devour. So we do try and be conscious of how many of those foods we're feeding our chickens, because if they're getting too many of those foods, they're gonna stop eating the greens and the good stuff that is so important for them too. So it's all a balance. So that pretty much sums up what we feed our backyard chickens. As always, I can only speak from personal experience, and I always recommend that you guys use me as one data point on a whole graph of opinion. So make sure you're doing outside research, especially when it comes to nutrition. That's pretty important. But I also want to be here to tell you guys, don't let it scare you away from chicken keeping, and don't get too worried about it, because especially if they can have access to the outdoors, they're pretty darn good at taking care of themselves. Not completely. I still recommend giving them plenty of layer feed if you can. Now that's my experience, but I would love to hear what you guys feed your chickens. So please leave a comment below with what you like to feed your chickens, maybe if you have specific brands you love, or how you save money on layer feed. All those kind of comments are so appreciated below. If you guys haven't already subscribed to our channel, don't forget to hit that subscribe button so that you can join us again in the future. And if you're not already following us on Instagram, our Instagram handle is oak_abode. Thanks for watching, and we will see you next time.